let's talk about what is really happening with the climate and what we really need to be concerned about. You do not need to be concerned with global warming. It does not exist. It ended years ago. Please spread that word. So what is happening with the climate? What is happening is exactly as I predicted it would in April and May of 2007, when I notified the White House and NASA, Congress, and the mainstream media. The Earth is going into many decades of very cold weather. It happens every 206 years on a cycle of the sun that is 206 years long, give or take a few years. That's what's happening. We know that has already begun, and we know it, as you can see from this chart. We measure it by sunspots, number one. A simple count of the sunspots drives the 90% accuracy on this model. All you have to do is follow the sun. Connect the dots by following the sun's dots or spots, and you know what's going to happen. It's that simple. This simple rule was set aside by the UN 20 years ago in the first UN report when they said the sun doesn't have any role. There's no need to track sunspots. It doesn't have any role. There's no need to track total solar irradiance. It varies too little to be a real indicator. They already had lots of bad science, yes. All of these indicators that I'm showing on this chart tell you that a solar hibernation has begun. Not only did NASA confirm it, but earlier this year, the U.S. Air Force and the National Solar Observatory have also indicated we're heading into a solar hibernation, and some of them said it's going to be worse than even I predict. It's going to be another little ice age when you could walk from Ellis Island to downtown Manhattan over frozen water, when you could walk across the frozen Thames River in London, when you could walk across much of the Baltic where they used to build hotels and stores on the frozen Baltic Sea because it was that cold year-round. We need to be very careful and prepare for what is coming. This chart and this list are just some of the indicators that we know that is coming. Typical sunspots, some of these are larger than the Earth. This is a blow-up. Now here's the chart that I wanted to get to. It shows you the track of sunspots. If you follow the 30-year average line in black, you'll see the Maunder minimum. And by the way, these low solar hibernation periods are given the name of a scientist who was most vocal or best documenting of that era. Dr. Maunder and John Dalton, the founder of the atomic theory, famous scientist, documented much of the temperature fluctuations in that period and were given the names. But basically, the Maunder minimum is right in the middle of the Little Ice Age. I'm saying it's going to be as cold as the Dalton minimum. We have just passed through the modern maximum. That's when the population of polar bears grew by 300%. And now we're heading down. I'll show you that chart, although it's posted on the back of the table as well. This is a chart from an associate who's been very helpful in coming up with the exact mathematical formula for my RC theory and the sun's cycles. I told him I don't need the theory today, but I do need your chart. Here's the chart. It shows going back to the last solar hibernation in here. And then it shows the fluctuations over time. If you look at the year 2030, 2031, which is what I calculated mathematically, that is the next low point. If you also look at that, you will see it is low or lower than in 1800. We're now about to enter a cold period that we have not seen for 200 years. Again, as I mentioned previously, there is no one alive today. And even if your grandparents and great-grandparents were alive and in here today, I could make this statement. There is no one alive today who's been through the depth and extent of the extreme cold we're about to face. This is a blow-up of that final period. It shows declining from, and this is a sunspot count, not a temperature, and I have an important point to make. Sunspots peaked in this area and are going to decline. When they're at their bottom, that's when the cold is. The temperature curve is different. There's a lag of about 30, 35 years in the temperature curve. My theory, the RC theory, relational cycle theory, is a cold weather climate theory. It's not about the warmth. It tells you when it's going to be cold. And that's the one I need to be concerned about. Because I'm not concerned whether polar bears are growing out of their bounds. I am concerned whether we have got enough food. And right now, I'm concerned that the cold is going to ruin much of our crops. And we'll get to that. Yes, sir.
How does this affect solar energy? Now, they're going to this solar energy. If we get into a low part, is the sun going to be colder?
You're not going to notice enough on a day-to-day basis. The sun is still going to deliver about 1,300 watts per meter squared. That's like having your microwave next to another microwave, as far as the eye can see, running every day. You're still going to get a lot of energy. It's the atmosphere and the oceans that are going to cool. This cooling has already started. This is the 100-year chart of global temperature. These next two charts will prove my point. If you look in the upper right, you'll see the curve has reversed. We're now heading down again. A steep downward curve like that happens only every 206 years. Look in the 1940 to 1980 range. You'll see it was cold. The Earth was cooling for 40 years. Somehow the global warming community lost that. But now we've reached the pinnacle, the peak, and now we're headed down. This chart shows the last 30 years. It shows you exactly where the peak occurred. By my calculations and previously announced, between 2005 and 2007. Here's the killer chart. The last 10 years, down. Make no mistake about it. And if you extend this chart back to 1998, 13 years of declining temperature. There's no growth in global warming for 13 years. There is no global warming. It's a myth. We need to tell our politicians, our leaders, to stop selling us this myth and start dealing with the truth. The Earth has been cold and cooling for 13 years. Yes, we're having multiple effects all descend on us at the same time. The 206-year cycle is the key driver, but under that you have many other cycles. They're also happening at the same time. That includes the La Nina cycles kicking back in earlier than people estimated. I did calculate that and estimated it would kick in when it did, when it is. And it does. Yes, ma'am. According to research done by myself and other scientists at the SSRC, when these cold cycles hit, we get the world's largest volcanic eruptions and largest earthquakes. It's going to be three barrels off of one gun, and all will produce harmful effects.
Space.com, I read on space.com, they predicted earthquakes happening in the Pacific because of solar things with the sun. Two or three days before.
Don't be confused with that. A lot of people are out there saying every time a solar flare hits the Earth, we get an earthquake or volcano. The data doesn't support it. What I will tell you is the macro data supports it. The solar cycles support it over a long-term trend. What we're working on and what others are working on is refining the predictive capabilities on especially earthquakes. We're getting better at it, or much better than most people think, but we're not there yet.
You need to listen, John.
No global warming. It's getting colder. We're going to start losing our crops. The worst year will be 2031, and I need everyone's support to stand your ground. Tell your newspaper, your TV, your politicians, whoever is telling you they're going to impose controls or taxes on you because of man-made global warming, there is none, and don't you do it. Thank you very much.
Thank you, John.